The stickiness of prices also affects the effectiveness of monetary policy. So if prices are completely flexible, like classical economists believe so, then when money supply increases, the interest rates does seem to decrease, but the increase in money supply causes price level to increase because there will be so much more money chasing the same amount of goods. So people take note that money supply causes inflation, and this means that while they see much more money circulating and probably much more money in their wallets, they know that it costs more to buy items. Hence, the actual prices of items are still the same. The real money supply is still the same. In this case, short-run interest rates simply don't change. Hence, short-term interest rates can never be manipulated in a classical model. Now, if you subscribe to this theory, then monetary policy is effectively useless to you. However, I'll advise you not to do this, because as we have discussed earlier, complete price flexibility is more of a theoretical tool than a description of reality. It does not happen in reality. In fact, price stickiness is more of a reality. In this case, we go to the Keynesian model that assumes price stickiness in the short run. If prices are sticky in the short run, then when money supply increases or decreases, and we suppose that it increases this time, then interest rates decrease. So the increase in money supply does not trigger increase in price levels in the short run because prices are sticky in the short run. Hence, this lower level of interest rate is present in the short run. However, in the long run, when prices are less sticky, and our short-run interest rate goes back to the long-run interest rate. Hence, while monetary policy may be effective in controlling short-term interest rate, it cannot affect long-term interest rate and will only contribute to inflation. This is one argument you can use against monetary policy.